Guest that I'm very excited about. I'm not sure that the guest herself is very excited. We've got the internet's most famous cat, the Grumpy Cat, and she's got a brand new book called The Grumpy Guide to Life, Observations by Grumpy Cat, and she's here with her owners, Tabby and Brian Bundeson, who are here to tell us all about it. By the way, I just have to say, first of all, my wife and I love your cat.
Thank you.
So there are lots of inspirational self-help books out there. This book, however, is a rich treasury of deep cynicism and antisocial sentiments. What is the message you are trying to get out to your readers?
Basically, Grumpy Cat's just trying to give some insight on how to live a grumpier life.
Do you think this could be helpful to people?
You know, absolutely. It's kind of like the other side of the road. You know, everybody's got a situation they need to respond to, and this will help with that.
So we've got some thought bubbles we want to have the Grumpy Cat fill us in on. So these are some quotes from the book, some items of wisdom for the book. So for example, the grass is always greener. How would the Grumpy Cat answer that? Well, the grass is always greener where you don't have to share it with anybody else. Let's try another one. If life deals you lemons, what's Grumpy Cat's verdict? If life deals you lemons, throw them at somebody. And finally, to be or not to be. How does Grumpy Cat answer this Shakespearean question? To be or not to be? I think you know my preference. And I think her face says it all there. So, Brian, you've got a big announcement. I should say more specifically, Grumpy has a big announcement this morning. What is it?
She does. Well, we have room for another stop on our book tour. We're with Chronicle Books, and they're hosting the Grumpy Town USA contest, where fans can submit their online ideas to bring Grumpy Cat to their hometown with the hashtag Grumpy Town USA.
So we've actually come up with some potential ideas. If people want to get ambitious, you can offer to throw a parade for Grumpy. You can also offer to make Grumpy a local photographer for your city hall, maybe the mayor's personal photographer, or the mascot of your local professional sports team. And one final question. She had a cameo recently on The Bachelorette. Can you tell us about that, Tabby?
I think they had a frown comparison there, and I'd say Grumpy Cat won that one.
Between Grumpy and Andy Dorfman? You think? Yeah, well, I would say Grumpy wins that hands down, although Andy's is not bad.
Yeah.
And we have to say before we let you go that the cat is actually quite sweet. Notwithstanding her facial expressions.
She's a sweetheart.
She's very friendly with strangers.
Absolutely.
And I've been petting her all morning, and I've been in the meanwhile pulling cat hair off myself obsessively. Thank you both really very much for bringing the cat in this morning. We really appreciate it. And we should say, The Grumpy Guide to Life, Observations by Grumpy Cat is available right now. It came out on Tuesday. And to learn more about the contest and see Grumpy's crankiest advice, go to our website, goodmorningamerica.com on Yahoo.